Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In part one of the pre-processing mini video series, we looked at how to change your media's import history settings in the middle of an edit by using the pre-processing editor. Another situation you encounter is when you have applied a ConnectFX timeline effects to a segment. All the settings are accessible, but the workflow changes slightly. So let's set up a scenario in Smoke. Here I have a simple sequence, and this segment has a ConnectFX timeline effects applied to it. Now, just to break this down, if we go into the ConnectFX node compositor, you can see that this composite consists of two source clips. Coming back to the timeline view, we have the single segment. So for example, if I wanted to change the pre-processing settings of one of those sources, selecting the thumbnail as before on the regular segment will not show the pre-processing editor. Where did it go? The answer to that question is contained within ConnectFX. Going into the ConnectFX, you can see the source clip in question has an R3D indication under the source thumbnail. Double-click on the source to access all of its menus. In the basic menu of the source clip, you will see an Import History title. Clicking Explode History creates a new source clip in the ConnectFX schematic with all the pre-processing settings exposed. From an operator's point of view, having the original clip and the new clip with the exposed settings allows you to go back to the original at any point. So you can now adjust the import settings of the media for the source clip and change it to whatever you want. As an example, let's say I want to key this image using the 2K resolution version instead of the original 1K version. So I'll change the debayering settings for the R3D file from a quarter to half good. The indications tell me that the file is now running at a 2K resolution setting. One other setting you need to change has to do with the way ConnectFX always processes at 16-bit float color space. When we exploded the import history of the original clip, it reset its settings back to 12 bits for this format. You can see a warning indicator appear in the other nodes telling you that there is a resolution issue. To correct this, go to the RGB LUT options in the source clips menu. Enable the active mode and change the setting to 16-bit float. This will push the image into 16-bit float space, but it should not decrease your system's performance. The warning indicators will disappear, and you can see the increased size and quality difference in the composite. You might need to make some adjustments to match the sizes, but at the end of the day, the image details is increased, making it easier to pull a better key. This concludes our two-part mini video series on pre-processing. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe for future videos coming from the Smoke Learning Channel.